Hello, I'm Graham Steele, CEO and founder of Cryptosense, and today in the fourth part of our series on Keystores, I'm going to talk about the Bouncy Castle Keystore, the BKS. So Keystores, as you'll know if you've seen the other videos, they are files which contain key data, so certificates and private keys, potentially symmetric keys as well that we're going to use in a program, and we've protected the values of those keys with some kind of encryption that's derived from a password. So that's how Keystores basically work. So the Bouncy Castle BKS key store derives its encryption key from the password, just like all of them do. It does that key derivation using an old version of the PBKDF function, so the password-based key derivation function that was defined in version 1 of the PKCS 12 standard. So this is now considered a legacy construction. It's not a NIST-approved way of doing that key derivation anymore. And that key is derived with a random number of iterations of the hash function SHA-1 on the password that you use. And that random number ranges between 1024 and 2047 iterations. So it's a bit of an unusual construction, but even 2047 iterations is considered too low for this kind of construction these days. The NIST minimum standard, even for PBKDF2, is 10,000, and we typically see hundreds of thousands of these around. And then the encryption that's done with the key that is derived is done with the triple DES algorithm. So as you know, if you've seen our video about that, that's not considered a secure block cipher these days. It's allowed in NIST standards for legacy until 2023 and only up to 2^20 blocks encrypted before you change key. So that should be just about okay for a key store. If you have some pathologically large key store, perhaps not. But anyway, it's a legacy cipher as well. So we're looking at a legacy way of building the key and then using it to do the encryption. So this should be getting the message across that BKS by now is a legacy construction for a key store. And you shouldn't be using this in applications. In fact, you should be trying to remove it if you have it even in some old apps. More than that, if you have an implementation of Bouncy Castle that you use to create the key store that is from version 1.47 or before, there's a bug in the way that the Bouncy Castle key store, the BKS, is constructed. That means that the MAC that's used to do authentication on the key store, so nothing to do with the encryption, but checking that the key store hasn't been tampered with, because of that bug, it effectively only has a 20-bit key. So a 20-bit key is completely trivial for your computer to figure out by brute force. So that would mean that somebody with the right access could tamper with that key store, put some fake certificates in there, make the HMAC that look right, and your application might go ahead and use those certificates, which would obviously be a problem. So you definitely need to get rid of BKS if you have it. If you have a BKS key store that's created using the old methods, you really, really need to get rid of it. And so you need to look at some of the alternatives. As you've seen some of our other videos, there are better key stores out there, or maybe getting rid of your old key store altogether. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching. Please go ahead and subscribe. Make sure you get access to all of the series about key stores and all of the other crypto news here at Cryptosense. And I'll see you again soon here on the channel.